live. It's Thursday, 7 o'clock Central. More terror attacks as part of the Saudi Arabian Jihad attack program. But first, a warning from Donald Trump about the parable of the snake. Get ready. We're live from Austin, Texas.
On her way to work one morning, down the path along the lake, a tender-hearted woman saw a poor, half-frozen snake. His pretty colored skin had been all frosted with the dew. Oh, well, she cried, I'll take you in, and I'll take care of you. Take me in, oh, tender woman. Take me in, for heaven's sake. Take me in, oh, tender woman. Sighed the vicious snake. This could be the great Trojan horse of all time. Because you look at the migration, study it, look at it. Now they'll start infiltrating with women and children. Take me in, oh tender woman. Take me in, for heaven's sake. Take me in, oh tender woman. Sighed the vicious snake. Now she clutched him to her bosom. You're so beautiful, she cried. But if I hadn't brought you in, by now, you might have died. She stroked his pretty skin, and then she kissed and held him tight. But instead of saying thank you, that snake gave her a vicious bite. I saved you, cried the woman. And you've bit me, heavens why. You know your bite is poisonous, and now I'm going to die. Oh, shut up, silly woman, said the reptile with a grin. You knew damn well I was a snake before you took me in.
From the front lines of the information war, it's Alex Jones.
Well, I had just gotten home to my family about an hour and 20 minutes ago. And no sooner had I kissed my children and smelled dinner cooking on the stove than I jumped back in my Dodge vehicle and drove back into the InfoWars News Center in South Austin. There has been another horrific terror attack confirmed with a truck running over 73 people that have died, many, many others wounded, with men firing machine guns that are totally illegal in France in a gun-free zone at the population that we're killing. Something ISIS just 2 weeks ago, this is up on InfoWars.com, DrudgeReport.com, of course, is covering it prolifically. And as soon as I got the call pulling into the house, I instantly went to InfoWars. I saw a few articles there. I went to Drudge, and there was images of just piles of dead bodies and the Eiffel Tower on fire, you know, just all sorts of craziness. They're claiming the Eiffel Tower fire is fireworks or something. They also claim San Bernardino was not a terror attack and was workplace violence. Hopefully it was just fireworks, but we're going to be tracking all of that. But here's what I do know. Criminal elements of our government are using radical Islam, which is really just Orthodox classical Islam, to attack Russia and to attack Europe and to attack Asia and to attack Africa and to attack North America. Areas that have never been Islamic in Central Africa are being invaded. People are being slaughtered by the tens of thousands. They're attacking and killing people on a weekly basis in China. I mean, this is getting out of control. Saudi Arabia runs Islam. 80% of Muslims follow the Sunni system that is basically controlled by the Wahhabists, who control Mecca, who are a radical form of the Sunnis. And they are taking the most vicious form that was ran the slave trade, taught Europeans how to do it. You cannot make this up. Mutilates women sexually, kills homosexuals on site, but then they're all into it themselves. I mean, it's some weird stuff. And Hillary is 20% funded by the Saudis alone. Something like 40% total with Gulf states. It's not even a campaign issue. And Donald Trump, for all his problems, he's not perfect, has the courage to talk about this and to have an advisor like General Flynn, who first exposed that our government is running Al-Qaeda and ISIS when he was the head of defense intelligence. So that's what's currently happening. That's what's currently unfolding. We saw them try to say that Orlando wasn't a terror attack. We saw them say that Fort Hood wasn't a terror attack for 4 years. We saw them say that attack after attack after attack, Army, Navy, Marine Corps recruiting centers wasn't a jihad attack. That they aren't on our southern border, that they're not coming through. We went down and proved it. Joe Biggs did, and our crew. This is serious. And 2 weeks ago, we have the articles on InfoWars.com. I'm going to go over them here in a minute. ISIS said, we're going to start hitting with trucks. And I've always pointed that out. You're not going to stop ISIS at the airport. You're going to stop them at the border. You don't move the checkpoints out to the highway, say at Austin Bergstrom. If ISIS hits, they'll drive an 18-wheeler full of gasoline or whatever into the checkpoint and blow everybody up. All you've done is create a target. You keep the drawbridge up. You don't lower it, let people in, and then post guards in every family's, you know, little hovel. And the bigger question is, why are they bringing him in? Why are they letting him launch a jihad attack? Why did they fund an Arab Spring to put these people in charge? Paul Watson is joining us from London, England. His family's from Sheffield. But because the economy shut down there, they've moved an area outside Nice where they actually own a bed and breakfast. Paul was just there a few weeks ago. He was there with the rest of our crew at the last terror attack, and there were no-go zones all over Paris, all over Brussels, Belgium, where they said, you get out of here, we're going to basically kill you. And the media said Trump was a liar, it didn't exist. So here's what we know right now. Daily Mail, 73, and the number's growing every few minutes, dead, at least 73 dead, and shots fired as lorry, that's a truck, rams into crowds celebrating Bastille Day, that's their Independence Day, that's like there's July 4th, in Nice, leaving bodies strewn across the road in suspected terror attack. It's now confirmed to be a terror attack. Now, here's the larger issue. France is the most tolerant place other than Sweden, bringing in massive groups of Muslims, giving them welfare, putting them in jobs, everything, but they attack it most. When you kiss its butt, like a pimp, it slaps you around. And they're increasing in frequency. They're getting more intense. They've brought in 5 million people the last 3 years into Europe. 80% of them, according to Interpol, are military age males with fake passports. They're not Syrian. They're the people that invaded Syria, a moderate Muslim country where Jews and Christians could live in peace with Muslims, where women got to go to college, where women were in jobs of authority and doctors and lawyers. No, 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 not now. We're going to Joe Biggs, who just drove right back into the studio when he heard we were about to go live. And I'm going to pop in with Paul Watson in London, England. But this is incredible. Trump has come out and said terror attacks are only going to get worse. Of course, they call him a conspiracy theorist. We have smoke and fire engulfing the Eiffel Tower. The police claim it's not Islamic. They claim for an hour it wasn't Islamic in Nice with guys shooting machine guns that were illegal. You can't buy in France that they're smuggling in and running over crowds of people jumping curbs. So that's all going on. And we've got some of that B-roll video we can roll whenever the crew wants to for viewers. But here's the number one thing. We're in an info war. And we need everybody watching to understand that we're live right now. We need everybody to send the links that are on InfoWars.com/show out. Because when you do that, we get 3-4 million new viewers and listeners. We've done this on election night. We've done this at Bilderberg. When you decide to share the links, when you decide to send the links out, when you decide that this is important, we can change the narrative. Because I'll guarantee you, they're going to be trying to say this is Islamic terror tomorrow. In fact, they're already doing it. Hassan shoots 14 people at Fort Hood, and they said it wasn't Islamic terror. He was getting direct orders from Anwar al-Awlaki. And again, the CIA knew for 2 years when it happened. Again, why are they doing this? That's the second part of this show tonight. We may go an hour, 2 hours live here. We already have the taped news that was about to go live. So we're going to be streaming for the next few hours here on UHF, VHF stations, cable stations like Houston and others that are picking us up, radio stations picking us up around the country as well. But what's important is we're challenging this narrative where Obama says you can't even say Islamic terror. And General Flynn said it was Islamic terror 2 years ago, and then Obama was aiding it. He was relieved of command. Trump supposedly considering him as a VP. I don't know if this Pence news is real. That's been, quote, suspended in lieu of terror attack. The word I got today, not from Stone, but he wouldn't talk about it, was this isn't what Trump actually was going to do. This is like some type of dirty op by the RNC. Well, now seeing Trump coming out saying this confirms that to a great extent, that Trump actually wasn't decided yet and had met with the four men he was looking at that event, including General Flynn, Senator Sessions, and then the horrible Newt Gingrich, and of course, Chris Christie. I don't like Chris Christie, but he's better than Newt Gingrich. Let me tell you, Newt Gingrich is a globalist. Just read his own writings. But we're going to be looking at all of this very, very carefully. What did Paul Watson write on July 11th, just 3 days ago? Head of French police, migrant sex assaults could trigger civil war. Because, I mean, France declared 6 months ago a civil emergency with the roads collapsing. We've shown you that there's hundreds of new videos a week in France of just thousands of people robbing families, pulling them out of cars, raping them, robbing, burning things. They'll just run out in the streets, start crapping on the ground. You got to understand, these Islamic countries are collapsing. Their populations have tripled the last 50 years. They're out in the middle of the desert, nowhere. They're following some crazy Islamic deal where women are chained up at home with their genitals cut off. They have the left's all worshiping them. I mean, this is insane. And I got to tell you, just at this point, as soon as I looked on the Drudge, it was like the burning Eiffel Tower and dead bodies everywhere. And I'm like, my God, how bad is this going to get? And again, I didn't want the clash of civilizations. I didn't want to invade the Middle East and overthrow moderates like Saddam Hussein and Assad and Gaddafi and Hosni Mubarak, who were stabilizers, and people had economies and tourism. Istanbul's collapsing in Turkey. No one's going there. It's an incredible city. All of this is happening. And now Paris, and tourism's went way down, but it doesn't matter. The jihadists, the Saudi Arabians, are giving billions a year, and sometimes personally the royal families and others, to sell out. Let's get Joe Biggs, combat veteran in Afghanistan and Iraq, who was just over in France a few months ago at the last terror attack and was run out with death threats all over. The police do nothing. I mean, it's crazy. Islam is not compatible with free Western religions. Will we bring anybody else in that sexually mutilates women and puts hoods over their heads? I just don't get why it's so protected. Joe Biggs, first look at this. We're about 2 hours into it. They tried to say it wasn't a jihad attack till video and witnesses said they were shooting machine guns out the windows of the truck. I know you've dealt with this, the use of trucks before. ISIS said this 2 weeks ago. What is your take on this? And can you believe they tried to spin this and said it wasn't a terror attack?
Well, it's interesting. This attack falls on the day that President Francois Hollande ended the declaration the emergency declaration that they had there in France. And now you have this truck that was plowing through people for up to 2 or 3 kilometers. And now they're saying that the back of that truck was full of guns, ammunition, grenades. So what I'm thinking is this truck was trying to head to a certain rally point, run over people, and then eventually terrorists on the sidelines were going to jump on the back of that truck and use those weapons. So it's only been confirmed that the one guy, the driver, was inside that truck. The French police took him out, and I believe that kept him from getting to the rally point where he was going to meet other terrorists to help take out this attack to another level. So that's really interesting to see that all unfolding right now. And like you said, you know, our own president is starting to bring these kinds of people into our country. Americans should be pissed off. You know, when I get on Twitter and I'm sitting here reading people's comments and they're like, oh, it's only going to be a matter of time before the right comes out and talks about how they want to be pro-Second Amendment. You know, what is it with these Yankees and wanting to have guns? Well, when ISIS came to Texas, look what happened. Two ISIS terrorists are dead
Texas
now.
Texas is the reason that ISIS was dead.
Yeah. So
30 seconds, killed them dead in a hammer.
We need an armed society. People need to have guns. The Second Amendment is a great equalizer between you and evil. When you take guns away, guess what's going to happen? They're going to find a car, a tractor trailer truck, and drive through you and mow people down.
That's right. Charlie Hebdo attack. This is like 3-4 times that number of dead. I've always pointed out, I mean, you can use anything as a weapon, and that's what the jihadis are doing. I know we're getting Paul Watson on the line. Do we have him on yet?
Negative.
Are we getting him on? You're trying to reach him. He is calling me. Let me give you that info. We're live on air right now. And I need Paul Watson on the broadcast. Paul, I know you're locked and loaded for 15 after at this time. We need you to go ahead and get connected with the guys. Or if not, I can take over and let somebody else take over, and I'll get you on the line. Let's get Paul Watson on. I want to get his breakdown on all of this. This is live, folks, news of this type that normally have 100 people on this, at Fox, CNN, this is real analysis, teleprompter free. We're going to get Paul Joseph Watson, who's staying up right now to get on the show, and we're going to get that set up. We're going to have that happen. Look, the frequency is intensifying. The left is allied with Islam, Joe Biggs. Joe, let me ask you this question. Why do you think the left is so allied with a group that is the most backward and twisted we can imagine? I mean, why would they attack ultra-liberal, socialist, kiss the butt of Muhammad and Islam? I mean, why do they tend to attack people that grovel the most to them?
I mean, I don't understand. I don't understand how the left can sit here and grovel at the feet of these kind of people when they openly call for the killing of homosexuals, they openly mistreat women, behead them without any kind of judge or jury. You know, they're allowing these radical Islamists to be judge and jury and to go out and conduct these killings, these mass killings, just like Paul Joseph Watson's called him many times, bloodthirsty psychopaths. That's what they are. And yet the left just sits there and bows down to their ever whimper, every need that they want and go, it's okay, let's be tolerant, let's be progressive, let's bring those people into America. We need that. No, we don't need another San Bernardino. We don't need another Orlando. Paris has been hit how many times? France and all has been hit how many times in the last 18 months? Belgium twice? This is out of control. At some point in time, these world leaders need to wake up and understand that being tolerant is stupid. Being tolerant is killing people. It's almost at a point where Islamophobia is a defense mechanism that people should almost
exactly.
be Islamophobic.
Joe, here's my deal. I was against the Iraq war like Donald Trump was because Saddam had been put in by the CIA, he stabilized the whole area. He was ordered to attack Iran. He did it. And then they set him up and then told him to invade Kuwait. I'm not saying he was an angel, but they had rock and roll on. 60% of their graduates were women. People could live in peace. Jews and Christians could live there. And then they overthrow him, and it's just crazy to see that Saudi Arabia wanted him out, and Saudi Arabia wants Assad out, and they wanted everybody else out. They wanted to bring down Hosni Mubarak because they want to take over, because they're 80% of Islam. They are the Sunnis.
My buddy's in Iraq right now, and he's actually in Erbil, Iraq, which is outside, it's southeast of Mosul, which has been completely taken over by ISIS.
Is that the same guys we had dinner with at the 4th of July?
No, that was another group of guys, but these are guys who are out there, and what are they doing? They have to rescue these Christian families that have been living in Mosul, and they're being taken to these tent cities to live in. Meanwhile, Obama's taking the radical jihadis and bringing them into America, and now we see what happens all across the country. Belgium numerous times, France numerous times. How many times does this have to happen before these world leaders open their eyes and actually pull their heads out of their butt and do the right thing? And then it's only going to be a matter of time before Fox, CNN comes out and they start blaming it on guns. Well, the back of the truck was full of guns. Well, the guns weren't used. They're going to completely forget that that truck was used as a weapon. You're not going to hear for a sweep of banning trucks.
They're smuggling the weapons in every attack. Remember the guy that tried to kill everybody on the train and American soldiers stopped him and they spun it and said he was just depressed and had a gun. He was shooting people. All I'm saying is, look, leftists intimidate anybody that lays down to them. That's why they bully patriots and libertarians and conservatives and veterans. They're actually scared of Islam, I think, and that's why they're bending over to it. And they are just such idiots to watch cowards like this try to ally themselves with this. Joe, makes me sick.
Well, I mean, all it's going to do is empower more attacks to happen. Like we see, the stuff continues to happen. These guys are getting emboldened. They're getting empowered. They see these other people doing it. They see them becoming martyrs, and they get off on that. And then social media, Twitter, Facebook, allow these people to go out there and openly call for the killing of Christians, the killing of Jews, the killing of homosexuals, and they do nothing to censor. But if I put up a picture of me holding a gun or talking about the Second Amendment, I'm told I'm a terrorist. I'm shut down.
Oh, we get censored all the time. All right, Joe Biggs, pop back in with us. I want to go to Paul Joseph Watson in a moment, about 15 minutes. We've got a special report John Bound filed that we're going to be getting to that is extremely important about the Day of Rage with George Soros. He'll fund right-wing Nazis in Ukraine, literal right-wing Nazis. Actually, Heil Hitler, that's who he put in as their first president. He'll fund the radical jihadist. They'll use anything to overthrow the civilization, then bring in total control. Let me tell you, that's why they're bringing in, it's got to be a million. They're keeping the number secret. Jihadis here, 5 million confirmed in Europe. First, they claimed it was 100,000. Remember that a few years ago? Because they're going to let them run wild, go crazy, and then take everybody's rights, saying don't have any free speech. That's what made the Muslims mad. I said that a few years ago. Germany and France and others have declared civil emergency and taken people's free speech. And then right when the martial law was rescinded today, as Joe Biggs pointed out. In fact, I want to go back to Joe if he's writing it into Paul. That's a key point you raised. They rescinded the martial law edict today, and the terrorist hit. He's already gone to the other studio. I'm going to ask Paul Joseph Watson what he thinks of this. Just briefly, it cost a lot of money to have Paul Watson and crew over in Europe, and his brother and other crew working with him, Steve Watson, with his degree in political science and international affairs. These are really educated, informed folks that are having a huge effect worldwide. It takes a lot to be getting ready to send 8 people, including myself, to the RNC next week. It takes a lot to be able to send a crew of 6 to the DNC. David Knight's going to that. It takes a lot to be able to cover Bilderberg and all these other big globalist events and the Trigglypuff social justice warrior events. It takes a lot to have Paul Watson up at 1 in the morning or 2 in the morning or whatever it is in London right now. And you know what? You've been supplying it. We give you the best nutraceuticals, the best durable foods, the best non-GMO seeds, the best Hillary for Prison and Molon Labe t-shirts, the best films, the best books, all of it at InfoWarsStore.com. And you built InfoWars. Stop thanking me. We're doing this together. Thank you. Let's just all have a group hug here. I mean, really. It's kind of sick when you thank me. We're in this together. This is history happening. Sure, I'm on enemies' list. Sure, they're coming after us. Sure. So what? I'm not a scumbag. I know we can have victory if we take action. All that evil men and tyrants need to flourish is that good men and women do nothing. So I want to thank you for your support. The 40% off on the best durable foods out there. There are the lowest prices. It's basically a lost leader at this price. It ends tonight, InfoWarsStore.com. The 10% off on all the nutraceuticals, X2, all of it, Living Defense, shortwave radios, that all ends tonight. 25% off DNA Force, that's running until next week. InfoWarsStore.com, InfoWarsLife.com takes you to the nutraceuticals. InfoWarsStore.com is the umbrella site. This is stuff that is super high quality. This is game changing. You think our info is powerful? We only promote and sell and develop products we use, we believe in. I mean, I am the most superstitious person on earth that I know. I don't mean about walking under ladders or don't break mirrors. I mean, I'm a little bit like that, or Friday the 13th type stuff, or knock on wood. I do that quite a bit. But so I'm, you know, I make a joke about myself, but I am superstitious. But my real superstition is God-fearing. And everybody knows this already. I only bring you the very best deals, the very best products at the very lowest prices we can get you. It doesn't matter. You're fun on the tip of the spear. You know the InfoWars hardcore. So InfoWarsStore.com, InfoWarsLife.com, or call toll-free 888-253-3139. If you want to see more reporters, more writers, more crew, more people in the field, more game-changing news, more of our stories and information and world understanding, realization, game-changing, we want to support you. Joe ran back, and I'm going to Paul Watson. It'll be more like 45 after now that I go to that tape and then bring in McAdoo and others. But I was asking you that question, Joe. What's your answer to it?
I didn't actually get a chance to hear that question.
I was just asking you. Well, Paul, you heard the question. Let's get Paul first. I'm going to pop back to Watson. Where do you think all this is going? Why does the left think they can get away with bringing these jihadis in? What do you make of this being the end of the martial law, civil emergency in France, the day it's ended and this happens, Paul? I mean, clearly the leftists are allied with Islam. They're bringing them in. They advertise the free goods. That's all on record. What the hell are they thinking? I don't see how they're getting away with this, Paul. What are they doing?
Well, I mean, with regard to them ending the so-called martial law, I don't think it really matters, Alex. I mean, they're going to attack soft targets. There's been an Islamist attack in France every other month for the past 18 months.
And that's the ones they don't cover up. We know they're covering up a bunch.
Exactly. So, I mean, I was in France, you know, a bunch of times recently. They've got security on the door at restaurants who aren't armed. It's complete theater. It's complete nonsense, unless you address the real problem, which is violent Islam and a policy of mass immigration and multicultural that brings these people in the first place. Okay, this is either going to be refugees, migrants who have snuck in over the past year, or it's going to be supposedly assimilated, integrated immigrants who have been in France for a number of years.
That's right. The last Paris attack person turned out to be a refugee who's involved bringing in refugees. Yeah. These are military officers involved in infiltration.
The mastermind of the Paris attacks bragged about how they exploited this refugee red carpet to plot and carry out the attacks. One of the individuals involved in the attack, Abdeslam, his friends and neighbors in Molenbeek protected him for months. this is not just about terrorists. It's not just about jihadists. It's about the wider support network of Islamists.
And why won't these governments that throw the book at patriots or citizens, why don't they go arrest, try, and string up the people that aid and abet this?
Because the left wants to destroy Western civilization. It's really important for people to understand this. It's not just a cliche. This is why ISIS, in its own manifesto, put out a few months ago, which we posted, said, we want to recruit left-wing activists, radicalize them, and give them weapons because they share the same agenda as us. They want to tear down Western civilization. This is what the left represents. It's this Saul Alinsky Marxist agenda. This is what's unfolding. This is why they protect and ally with the Islamists. And you can look at France. Here's some more facts. Okay, Pew Research, they asked French people, people in France, Muslims, if they support suicide bombings. The Muslims living in France right now, 35% of them support suicide bombings under some circumstances. When you ask 18 to 29-year-old Muslims in France, 42% of them support suicide bombings. So it's not a tiny fringe.
And by the way,
we're
pulling up that tweet. I saw Molyneux put it out. Mainline study, mainline poll. I want you to retweet it. We'll post it to InfoWars. We need to send it to Drudge. I mean, it was 25% a year ago. Now it's 30-something percent saying jihad inside the West and kill everybody.
Yeah, notice that the younger generation, the supposedly more connected, you know, more modern, more progressive generation, they actually support violence even more than older Muslims. So this problem is getting worse and worse. Then you've got the angle of this. Every time a black person gets shot, we see the video. It's a massive national controversy. We see it on Facebook, millions of views. We see it on Twitter. We see it everywhere. They won't show the bodies. They won't show the attack of what happened in France. Show the bodies. They showed the dead, washed up body of that kid in Turkey to sell us on this refugee agenda. They won't show the dead body of a little girl with a baby doll next to her in Nice, in France. They won't show it on TV continually. I was watching Sky News. They were blaming Brexit. They were saying, oh, it's because we can't share intelligence with the French that this has happened. We haven't even left the EU, for God's sake. You've got people on CNN saying that the result of this attack will move Europe to the right. And that's the major problem that the right will be involved in.
And notice that we got Pew Research here with 37% of the Muslims. We can put it back on screen. Saying they support this. This just came out. 18 to 29, 35% support. And that is, and of course, folks, that's crazy. You know, it's way higher than that when you're being asked, are you support killing people? This is bold. This is bold craziness. Why would you bring people in that support just randomly going out during a national holiday and just murdering French people? I mean, my God, can you imagine France compared to the Middle East, how beautiful it is, how nice it is, how good the food is? The French women are all liberal and just grovel and want to be pimped, want to be, you know, put in slave pits. You'd think they just want slave pit slaves, but they don't. They just want to kill themselves. It's like the German minister that got raped by the Muslims and she covered it up and said Germans did it. Who the hell are these people? What happened to them?
I think the thing about it, Alex, is they want the world to be how they think it should be, not how it actually is. So as long as they stick their head in the sand every time something like this happens, they think it will just go away. Okay, there's the top trending hashtag on Twitter right now, as it is every single time this happens, is pray for Nice. Okay, that's not going to do anything. Hug a Muslim is not going to do anything. The top trending hashtag should not be pray for Nice. It should be fight for Western civilization.
Absolutely. I'm coming right back to you. Let's put it out. Hashtag fight for Western civilization. And we're going to put that on InfoWars.com. Tweet that out, Paul. Take a moment. Do that. Tweet it out. Everybody's going to do that right now. I'm going to go to Joe Biggs, who's, and again, the West isn't perfect. We've gone and done bad things in these countries to back the bad guys. It's clearly a master plan. There's evil all over. I think this is going to backlash on Muslims down the road. That's part of the larger globalist plan. We know that. In fact, I don't think that. That's the PNAC clash of civilizations. Regardless, though, it's wrong to bring in the most backward Muslims, let them do this. Why would they come into somewhere that welcomes them, free welfare, everything, bends over, and then do this? Why do this to the French that are so incredibly socialist, so pro-Islamic? Why, Joe Biggs?
Destabilization happening right now. You know, we have in America one of the strongest countries that will really stand up and fight against these crazy leftists. And now we have within Obama, he is internally trying to destabilize America. They're taking the George Soros money. They're funding these days of rage that are allowed to happen tomorrow. Then there's also going to be the massive protests with hundreds of thousands of people that are paid by George Soros to come in and destabilize and then demonize the local law enforcement to instill a federalized
police report. I agree. So what's coming next? It looks like it did in the beta test. It looks like they're making their move worldwide.
Yes, this is it.
I never saw communist flags. Everywhere I go, just red flags are running around, giggling. I mean, it's crazy.
Obama's leading it. He wants to take down America so they can take out this global plan to destabilize everything, put in one world government, and then use the UN to take over and run all these different countries. It's out of control.
And then it's going to come in as the savior and bioweapon Africa and kill them. I mean, and what's sad is they're clearly setting the Muslims up. And I'm not defending the horrible thing they're under and the stuff that happens. But, I mean, clearly, this isn't some white guilt or Western guilt.
The Military Times is already writing articles talking about how the UN's going to be able to go against American citizens. It's in our face. They don't even hide it anymore. It's full throttle right now. They want to tear America apart so they can go on and completely destabilize the entire planet.
I'll say this, Joe. I know you've been a viewer for a long time. Before you worked for the last 3 years. But, I mean, it's crazy for me to see everything we warned of because we had the documents and the experts, the advisors. We just knew the facts and we went with it. We didn't care what people said about us. But it's surreal to see everything we warned of now starting to happen. And it's not fun to have our credibility rise. It's not fun to be proven right. It's actually a very sick feeling.
Yeah, there was a guy arguing with me on Twitter earlier as this attack was unfolding. He's like, why do you think that we should arm all citizens? I was like, well, look at this. San Bernardino. Pretty gun-free zone. Orlando nightclub, gun-free zone. Paris, Belgium, all these areas get hit because they are gun-free zones. They are soft targets. An armed populace will stop these kinds of things. Maybe not a car bomb, but a good bulk of these attacks that are being carried out.
Sure, but how could Obama, with Air Force One, red carpets, all this power, go to Africa and say, you can't have cars or air conditioning? How can he hate the West? How can George Soros, who's just gotten away with everything, why do they hate us? All they do is demonize the West. I've been to other countries. This country isn't perfect, but my God, they're trying to kill what is special about it. I want to go back to Paul Watson. We'll come back to you, Joe. We're going to play a clip here in a few minutes, but we've got Leanne McAdoo and others coming in here. And we do this live. We're live right now. It's 7:32. Five more minutes, Watson. Other key points. 70 plus dead. In fact, the number's going up right now. Truck running over people, machine gunning people. Supposedly, what do we know about the hostages? Is this accurate? It's in the news that hostages at nightclubs, hostages at hotels, Paul.
They're saying that the hostage thing is not happening now. We don't know. I mean, this could get even worse.
So San Bernardino was workplace violence. Maybe it's workplace violence.
No, exactly. I mean, I was watching Sky News, and because there was a mistranslation with the French president who said this is a criminal act, they immediately seized on this, and they were like, oh, maybe it is just a criminal act. And they will seize on anything to do. Other key points, the head of the French police, and this article was up 4 days ago on Infowars.com, said one or two more terror attacks or one more mass molestation, like we saw in Cologne, like we've seen in Sweden repeatedly over the past week. Women literally being raped in the middle of concerts by these Muslim migrants. He said that's going to trigger civil war in France. But of course, who did he blame? He blamed the right wing. So again, don't address the actual source of the problem that is causing all this resentment, this violence. Just blame it on the right wing. And we had another report today on Infowars.com. The French government has come out in the parliamentary report about the Bataclan theater massacre, covered up the fact, we know from eyewitnesses that they said people were being tortured, they heard the screams, that how they were being tortured. People literally had their testicles cut off and shoved in their mouth. People were beheaded. People were having their eyes gouged out during that Bataclan theater scene.
Well, that's the thing, is I was reading about ISIS, is if they think you're gay, like 50 dudes will rape you and then shove your testicles in your mouth. It's like a demon group. It's like, as long as they're raping you because you're gay, it's okay. Or they'll rape a six-year-old girl like 100 guys till they die, and then they are proud of it. Who are these people? I mean, that's what I'm saying, is that it's like, what the hell? What the hell is wrong with these governments?
It's cultural enrichment, Alex. We should welcome it. Refugees welcome. But they covered it up. They covered the fact that people having their testicles cut off and shoved in them is a common Islamist atrocity that we've seen throughout the Middle East, because they thought it would offend Muslims. Again, same with San Bernardino. They were shipping in the weapons, the explosives, to this apartment. The neighbors saw it. They didn't report it because they feared being labeled racist.
Was that something, political, I mean, where do they get to cut the testicles off or rape little girls? I mean, is that, did Muhammad teach that, Paul?
Well, Muhammad was a pedophile, and that's the point. They're following the dictates of somebody who urged them to go out and kill the infidels. Islam has been at war with the West for 1,400 frigging years. Why is this a surprise to us? You asked earlier, why are they doing this? Well, because it's not a religion of peace. Read the frigging Quran and say, oh, yeah, but if you kill one non-Muslim, you kill. They say that's in the Quran. Well, yes, but it's completely contradicted by numerous other passages in the Quran which say, kill the infidels, smite them at the neck. That's the religion they're following. It's not a religion of peace. And until we realize that, until we stop shouting down the voices of reform, the ex-Muslims and the Muslims who are saying we need to reform this religion, it's violent, it's barbaric, it's intolerant, we're going to see this again and again. An attack every other month in France alone. Europe's turning into Israel. We predicted that years ago. It's happening.
And again, the governments love it because they can pose as a saviors, because they think they've suspended logic, where they blame the right wing because they brought in 5 million jihadists. And I see the videos, and I've been to Europe, and you just go there, and it's like all the major cities are basically Islamic. They ought to be happy. They conquered it. They took it over. If they just shut up and bring more folks in, they could do it and have the women all chained up, but they can't help it. They want to start showing off to their family, getting the Saudi Arabian money. It's well known. When they go shoot people or blow something up, $1 million gets sent to mommy. And as long as mommy's allowed to not be thrown in prison, this is going to keep happening, Paul. I don't want to torture mommy. I want to show her talking to her son, telling him good job, and I want to lock her ass up. If my mother was supporting me killing people, she should have her ass locked up. I'm sick of this. We're a bunch of cowards and punks putting up with this crap.
And the other argument, Alex, is, oh, it's just economics. These people are poor. They're desperate. Well, no, if you actually look into suicide bombers and Islamists, a lot of them are very well educated. Then they say, oh, well, it's just backlash against Western imperialism. It's enshrined in their own Sharia-based law that they barbarically kill people.
Well, let's blame some imperialism. And I'm not blaming, you know, all of us listen to this show, myself have, you know, a connection to England, and America was founded by it. So it's good things happen too. But the British royal family and MI6 and MI5 and OSS before that helped set up the Saudis as their horrible little nasties in there. So it's not imperialism's the backlash, though. Imperialism runs radical jihad, and there is a sick imperialism, globalist imperialism, allied with it, Paul.
I'm saying you can oppose that. You can oppose attacking Libya, handing it over to jihadists, but you can also oppose Islam because it's the intolerant religion. It's holding two thoughts in your head at the same time. Can we do that? Well, no, leftists can't do that. Now we've got, you know, like Black Lives Matter people on Twitter saying, here's one of them. I suppose France can't be a tragic accident. It has to be something that gets white people all scared and bothered. So within minutes of this attack,
Black Lives Matter makes a joke. Yeah, well, let's expand on that. The controlled corporate left is a destabilizer. Soros funds all this, and so they're allied with it. And it's very, very sad to create division. And I've seen this whole thing where, you know, it's the cops' fault they got killed, because we see the videos, the out-of-control cops, which there are some bad ones. It's just, the point is, the establishment wants a revolution against local government instead of actually a revolution against the globalists that have hijacked the country. That's a restoration. I want to go to Kit Daniels and a final comment from Paul. We're going to play a tape from John Bowne and then bring in, several of our reporters to give their take on this. We're going to bring in Margaret and Leanne. But let's go to Kit Daniels, who is here working, again, almost 8 o'clock at night Central. He's been there since 7 o'clock this morning. I'm just pointing out what a great crew we've got. I'm so proud of them. Fox News, they come into a one-hour show, 2 hours of preparation. It's all scripted. I'm not bashing Fox. I'm just saying this is real analysis. This is real information. And our crew are really great folks. Kit Daniels, unscripted. I don't know your take on this. Tell us.
Yeah, I saw this interesting article on RT. It says, why has NATO chosen Russia as its enemy instead of ISIS? Now, you remember a couple of months back, the Russian Air Force, they basically bombed a third of ISIS into abolition. And, you know, it was only a couple of months, where I think it was like 4 or 5 months of bombing, and poof, 33% of ISIS was completely gone. And so this columnist points out that the main reason is because there's very little profit in combating Islamic State. And NATO is primarily a money racket, which provides a lot of influential people with a very comfortable lifestyle flying around the globe.
They want to build up giant weapons and make the Russians bankrupt themselves countering it.
Yeah, exactly. And let's not forget why ISIS was funded by the State Department and the Pentagon, like in 2012, even before that. You know, it was to topple Assad in Syria to help the NATO ally Turkey, which is in NATO, but yet it's one of the biggest sponsors of terrorism, just like Saudi Arabia.
And it's the gateway for the Islamic invasion into Europe.
Yeah, exactly. And that's also another thing that's been feared about Turkey joining the EU is because once you have Turkey's in the EU, all the citizens get visas to enter any single country. That's the biggest fear, is the fact that ISIS can exploit that. You know, use Turkish visas.
And again, nobody, Islam's all loving. Turkey was Istanbul.
Yeah.
Turkey.
Before it was Constantinople before that.
Exactly. It was Constantinople. It was taken over and hundreds of thousands were murdered.
What's interesting now,
sold into slavery.
It's going back 1,000 years. The reason the Turks took over Asia Minor from the Byzantines was because the Byzantines started pulling back on their borders. They stopped controlling their border. They actually took families that were living on the frontier land and moved them back. That allowed all the Turks, even the precursors to the Ottomans, to move into the
continent. No, that's it. We're dealing with Stone Age crazies, slavers. I mean, they wrote the book on slavery, and we're so dumb, we won't even point out that the West was taught about slavery, and Christians actually fought it. Took them hundreds of years to actually ever stop it. But there was a movement to stop slavery from day one, and it's just all been written by the Muslims. And again, it's just history. I'm sick of being blamed for everything. This is crazy. And we've got to stop it.
Yeah, Alex, the other thing that realize is the fact that Christianity were the first people to stop slavery. I mean, before Christianity, you had certain groups that were against slavery, but only
everybody
if it was
it.
Yeah, only if it was against their people being enslaved. It was the Christians that pointed out, hey, let's not enslave humans, period. But then
I know,
you have,
so we get the blame for it. Yeah. I know, it's just insane.
And then people forget the Ottoman Empire was one of the biggest slave trading, I think it was the biggest slave trading empire. For like 500-600 years. Also, another thing I want to point out is the fact on Twitter, the leftists are complaining about people sharing the videos of this attack, saying it's too brutal, you know, so on and so forth. But these same liberals are the ones that are sharing police brutality videos. So this is complete disconnect,
and again,
complete
I want to be
hypocrisy.
Clear. We don't just blank check defend the police. I literally wrote the books and films on the police state trying to stop it. But now I realize they want to overthrow it completely and bring in a globalist thing through the police state. I want to try to reach out and reform things and not have a civil war. Kit Daniels, incredible points. Thank you so much, my friend.
Yeah, thank you, Alex.
Great job to Don Salazar and Mikhail Thalen and just everybody up here. And I can't thank everybody from just everybody here, an amazing crew. You, the viewers, you, the listeners. McBreen. I was saying Darren McBreen. He just popped in with a handsome Irish devil over there. What do you think of this whole thing, my friend?
Well, we got some breaking news. Rob Jacobson and I just attempted to put a video, the Donald Trump snake video, right? And we wanted to put that up on Facebook because, as you know, he's warned the world about these terrorist attacks for months now.
For years.
All right. So this is interesting. And Jacobson, come in here. You can help me out. But you know the meta tags. When you put something up on Facebook, you want to put keywords in there so people are able to better find your
video.
Sure,
that's how they know what it is. Yeah, it's like it's a thing about foodie stuff, about short ribs, you put short ribs in. If it's a thing about, you know, a rock concert with Van Halen, you do that.
That's right. So Jacobson simply attempted to type in Muslim terrorist. Not only was it rejected, and by the way, we got this on video. We're going to put a report out real soon.
Oh, my God.
Not only was it rejected, but it came up with a suggestion, and wait for this, you're not going to believe it. Muslims are not terrorists.
Oh, well, that's Obama says video. You can't say it.
Yeah.
It's this crazy monotheistic chauvinist. I have daughters. I am threatened by this. And then I'm the bigot. I'm the anti-female because I'm totally threatened by this. I mean, I just, and I'm not patronizing women or even virtue signaling. I freaking spoil my women. They're mine by mine. I mean, I love them.
Hey, don't forget.
I am so freaked out by this. I just to see, oh my God, I this is the craziest thing I ever. We know it's getting worse. I mean, it's like when I try to put a cuss word on my iPhone, it won't let me say it. This is the next level of that. Jacobson, what happened?
Well, Alex, we did actually a couple of search terms. We did terrorist, which returned us the mandatory search return of Muslims are not terrorists. We did radical Muslim terrorism, in which case nothing came up on the suggestion list, but when we press enter, it would not allow us to enter that term. Radical Muslim
scandal. We need big articles on this.
Muslim terrorism also. We were not able to enter Muslim terrorism. It would not return on the tag.
See, that's why I want to mount cameras, except we have codes and private stuff, so we can't do it. And but cameras everywhere, so you can see what we deal with every day. Like, Hillary had the biggest exclusion zone in history over the RNC and DNC, so we can't fly airplanes. That's never been done before, 30 miles out. I mean, you know, with Hillary for prison signs, this is crazy, McBrain.
Well, and Alex, don't forget, it was just earlier last year, it was Mark Zuckerberg was caught on a hot mic talking with German Chancellor Angela Merkel.
About censoring people.
About censoring. And she says that we really need you to start censoring people on these Muslim migrants. And he says, we are working on it. And since that happened, I mean, what else? We got
And by the Facebook way, people can say story. There's some red herring. We're overreacting to this. No, 5 million people in Europe in 3 years. There's something big. Let me ask you both.
The floodgates are open.
This is huge. What do you think's really behind this, Jacobson?
Oh, I think it's basically what we talk about all the time. It's a combined effort to undermine Western civilization. I mean, basically what Watson was just discussing. I mean, it's pretty obvious. You have on one side this leftist takeover, and on the other side you have, you know, you can't criticize, you can't talk, you can't even discuss Muslims, you can't talk about
peanut
radical
butter
Islam.
And jelly sandwiches are racist. Guys cutting women's genitals off right. With bags on their heads, fine. But you got a peanut butter and jelly sandwich, you're guilty.
And it's not just, it's happening all across of Western civilization, whether it's America, Europe, you know, anywhere that's westernized is going to have some sort of Muslim terrorist kind of action or leftist terrorist kind of action as well. As these people terrorize our minds, we're not allowed to talk, we're not allowed to express ourselves, criticize or do anything. And at the same time, the Muslims are actually causing violence, deaths, and killing.
You can't call it Muslim terror.
I can't even put the term into the thing. Yep. The video's about Muslim terrorism. That's what the video's about.
That's who's doing it.
Yeah, that's what's going on. I tried to enter the term, and it will not allow me.
I mean, if there was some crazy Christian group doing this, we'd say Christian terrorists.
Right. That's right, and you can enter anything else. I mean, we tried multiple different terms,
guys,
multiple different phrases.
Get this
phrases,
video
so.
Up. Take a clip from the show right now. Put it. It's going to go viral. Drudge is going to pick it up, I bet.
Right.
And this is insane. And I'm not picking a fight with Facebook. We reach people there. But, I mean, they're just incredible censors. He calls his users dumb efforts.
Mm-hmm.
Great job, guys. We're going to go over, folks, over an hour here tonight. I'm going to bring in Leanne McAdoo and Margaret and others here soon. Paul Watson, closing comments from London, England, my friend. You're pretty close to Nice and Paris right now.
Closing comments are... France is basically gone. I mean, it's like Belgium at this point.
It's like California.
Will this lead to Marine Le Pen? Will that be enough? Who knows by now? I think what will move it possibly is if this happens in Germany. We've seen there was a massive attack planned in Dusseldorf. Basically, Germany is Europe at that point. It's how they react to that terror attack, which is inevitable. They brought in 1 million+ of these people. So that's going to really tell how it's going to, you know, pan out going forward.
And that's just the latest wave. That's just the latest wave.
Yeah.
The globalists think we're going to capitulate to this. Go ahead.
Final comment is a quote from Hillary Clinton. Quote, let's be clear. Islam is not our adversary. Muslims are peaceful and tolerant people. Nothing whatsoever to do with terrorism. Don't let this woman anywhere near the White House. Period.
All right, Paul. They're going to be covering it at InfoWars.com. I know. What time is it in Albion?
It's coming up to 2 a.m., but I'll be all night working.
Oh, we love you. What a gosh. I tell you, you're a great American, Watson. Best American I know. It's true. That's what founded America. These great redcoat creatures. That's what I'm one of those too. Hey, I tell you, it is awesome to see everybody across the world waking up to what's going on. And I tell you, Saudi Arabia is just pure evil, and so is China. But I tell you, it's really evil is the globalists that are running this whole show. They're really evil. They're against humanity, and they're bringing in incompatible crazies to just shake up societies, think about everybody's speech, to finally end, you know, the scourge of the terror attacks. And I told you, it used to be every year. Now it's every month, every week. Boom, 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 boom. And, you know, we could live with terror attacks. It still wouldn't kill as many people as cars. But they're going to use it to take our rights. That's why I'm taking Islam on head on. Because it's crazy. I can't go to these countries and preach Christianity or preach liberalism or preach Confucianism or animism or Zoroastrianism or Buddhism, whatever I wanted to teach. I can't teach anything. So why do I got to then have you here, give you everything, and watch you blow stuff up all day and then bitch about it with a bunch of leftists patting you on the head and weird videos our crew gets of little, you know, high school and college feminists with feminists on their face going, Alex Jones hates Muslims. I mean, who am I hurting? I'm a flaming liberal, man. I'm for freedom. Do what you want. Don't hurt me. Leave me alone. Oh, no, though. They're the new liberals, and they're allied with Saudi Arabia and a bunch of cult leaders. That's why we got something in liberal countries called right to self-defense. It's so liberal. I got 250 cals about 20 feet from me and an M4 and a 357. It's so liberal that I know how to fight back and break people's noses if they attack me. It's so liberal that I'm a loving, big old sweet kitty cat. But you attack me, I'm going to attack you right back. I'm not a victim. And that's what freedom's all about. Let's go to this clip on John Bowne. We're bringing in some of our reporters to talk about what's happening. Stay with us.
Oh. 37 cities have been designated for a Day of Rage, slated to begin around 7 p.m. Eastern Time. The cities announced by Anonymous include Phoenix, Arizona, Tucson, Arizona, San Francisco, California, Oakland, California, Los Angeles, California, Denver, Colorado, Washington, D.C., Atlanta, Georgia, Tampa, Florida, Orlando, Florida, Miami, Florida, Chicago, Illinois, Des Moines, Iowa, New Orleans, Louisiana, Baltimore, Maryland, Boston, Massachusetts, Detroit, Michigan, Lansing, Michigan, Ann Arbor, Michigan, Minneapolis, Minnesota, St. Louis, Missouri, Carson City, Nevada, Manhattan, New York, Newark, New Jersey, Durham, North Carolina, Columbus, Ohio, Cleveland, Ohio, Portland, Oregon, Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, Nashville, Tennessee, Memphis, Tennessee, Austin, Texas, Salt Lake City, Utah, Seattle, Washington, and Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Although Anonymous is calling for peaceful protests, we should quickly remember that the attack on the Dallas, Texas Police Department that occurred last week began peacefully. Unbelievably, George W. Bush appeared to be beside himself with psychopathic glee when he recently attended the memorial service for the slain Dallas police officers. President Obama is reacting in his typical way as well. Rather than doing what any U.S. president would do in the wake of a rash of attacks on police officers from Texas to Michigan, working towards peace and distancing the country from division, Obama, of course, immediately met with the UN-backed and George Soros-funded Black Lives Matter representatives to apparently war game the Day of Rage on July 15th.
UN invites Black Lives Matter to event. UN rights expert cites structural and institutional racism in the U.S. at CNS News. The UN runs Black Lives Matter through the Open Border Foundation, Open Society Foundation that Soros puts billions into. Billions with a B. So, of course, they're part of the UN. It's the Strong Cities Initiative.
Now, in a movement like Black Lives Matter, there's always going to be some folks who say things that are stupid or imprudent or overgeneralized or are harsh. And I don't think that you can hold well-meaning activists who are doing the right thing and peacefully protesting responsible for everything that is uttered at a protest.
The term Day of Rage was first used by the Weather Underground, the radical leftist socialist organization that targeted government buildings and banks in the 1970s, members of which, including Bill Ayers and Bernadine Dorn, have contact with President Obama to this very day.
The one thing I'm certain of is that whatever the 60s was and whatever this product is that they're selling us, it was prelude to today. And the question is, what are we going to do now? Leaning forward, not what was the great glory of the past. I think that's kind of a nonsensical way to think.
In the words of the document that created the Weather Underground, quote, a revolutionary mass movement is different from the traditional revisionist mass base of sympathizers. Rather, it is akin to the Red Guard in China, based on the full participation and involvement of masses of people in the participation in the practice of making revolution, a movement with a full willingness to participate in the violent and illegal struggle, end quote.
There were telephoned bomb threats to 22 other Washington buildings yesterday and two more today, all false alarms. Credit for the Capitol bombing was claimed in a letter received by the Associated Press today, signed by the Weather Underground and postmarked Elizabeth, New Jersey. Nevertheless, Attorney General Mitchell said today there is no evidence of a conspiracy, just a lot of people getting in on an act.
Every radical organization will descend on the aforementioned targeted cities. There could very well be shootings, rioting, and protesters blocking traffic. Steer clear of these protests if you live in any of the 37 cities mentioned. Obama's fundamental transformation of America is accelerating. John Bound for InfoWars.com.
Brain Force is here. Ladies and gentlemen, I've been on this the last few months. You probably noticed I've been more crazed, more focused, less brain fog, more energy, more special reports, and it's because of Brain Force.
One of the worst things with most energy products is it's not sustainable, right? You're gonna crash and gonna feel really bad afterwards. This has a bunch of different antioxidants and compounds and polyphenols.
Everybody's on these drugs to knock their brain out because the brain's so fried.
We kept changing this formula over and over and over again. For example, the L-theanine inside of it, that is activated by the different compounds in the yerba mate that we put inside of it as well. This just increases the compounds you already have.
This is what you're actually designed to run on.
Exactly.
It's kind of like a car will run on one form of junkie gas, but it runs really good on what it's designed for. You will find Brain Force, Survival Shield X2, and other game-changing products at InfoWarsLife.com or call 888-253-3139. Ladies and gentlemen, we are back, and Margaret Powell is with us. Also, we have Leanne McAdoo, just back from her vacation, visiting with family, and she's here to see this. You're here to see this. We of course, tape the news. Some nights it's live. Much of the news we did tape, this started happening around 5:30 while you guys were taping the news, so that's going to air right when this ends. A lot of, you know, key news on other subjects. What is it like for you to see 73 and growing dead, run over by a truck in Nice, a guy shooting people with machine guns, other events happening? Looks like they're trying to cover that up. You know, they said Fort Hood, Major Hassan won a terror attack. It was workplace violence at the San Bernardino, on and on and on. Army-Navy recruiting centers, guys saying Allah Akbar, shooting Philadelphia cops in the head. I mean, this is clearly a global jihad being launched, Saudi Arabia involved. What is it like for you? Because during the break, Facebook mentioned folks saw it, but other people didn't. I've told the story, and folks, I mean, I just tell you like it is. I've never had an anxiety attack in my life, not being physically attacked, mugged, you name it. I've been out at areas like the Domain and Barton Creek, and I see women in full headdresses covered up with their men dragging around like they're dogs. And I've got my daughters, and I see these men, you know, very aggressively. I mean, you see these Islamic teachers and stuff, it's the same thing. It's, you know, pointing at my daughters. And I just have a palpable, like a big mean pit bull's growling at you, actual, like, whoa, because it's just sudden. It's a massive invasion. It's globalist run. They've covered up the numbers. First, Leanne McAdoo, watching this in Nice, watching the other attacks, watching them being covered up. What is your visceral response to this?
Well, I instantly started crying, of course, because I had the unfortunate experience of watching one of these videos playing on Twitter. And to actually see the aftermath before it was blurred out, before they tell you, oh, you know, it was just a horrible.
Because we're a news center. You were watching it right as it happened.
Yeah, so I'm watching it as it's playing out, what we're able to see, what isn't being censored or omitted by the Obama administration because they don't want to offend Muslims, so they don't want to show this. People need to see this. I mean, I believe Kit Daniels brought this up, that, you know, they're going to put out videos of police shootings, graphic videos. And why do they do that? To get people upset, to get people pissed, to get people activated to fight against what.
Imagine if police just killed 73 people tonight. We at least say it was police. Right. They won't even say it's Islam.
Yeah, and then the president comes out, of course, President Obama, and once again, he's like, we are very sorry for what appears to be another horrific terror attack. When will he say radical Islamic terrorism? When we find out what this guy's name is, probably even then, they're going to say that he was a French national and, you know.
A Frenchman.
He was just really upset about the Bastille Day or whatever. You know, this is what Islam, this is what it looks like there for 1400 years. This is what is being taught there to.
You were just in Spain. That was invaded and overrun.
Portugal, yes.
Portugal.
Yeah. No, it's, I mean, here's the video. You can see it. It's totally graphic and.
So we're not going to censor this for our viewers.
I'm really sorry for anyone that has to be seeing this, but this is what they don't want you to see. They don't want you to see what is happening to our country.
And these
here.
Are ultra liberal French that are just out having a drink at night being murdered.
These are people celebrating Bastille Day, watching fireworks out with their families. There's children, the bodies of children out there just being plowed through. And then after he drives the truck for a mile, he drives his truck through, plowing through these people watching this. Then he jumps out of the truck and starts shooting the rest of the people that are surviving this horrific attack.
And then Hollande will get up and act like a hero, and he's the one that is allowing all this.
Right. And it was good.
Well, you know what? They're like 30% Islamic now, and they say at that point it's over. They know they can't deport the people. It's over, man. It's either kill or be killed. And I think France will bend over and take it. I think they'll convert.
Right. And but you're not going to have a lot of people who haven't assimilated into the French culture out celebrating Bastille.
How? Why the hell would you leave the Middle East and want to overthrow France?
Right.
I mean, the food, the culture, why would you want to overthrow that?
Right. And it would have been a lot worse than what we are seeing here, because they actually, the truck was filled with guns and grenades, probably shipped in, accidentally dropped to them by the West. So.
Wow, Leanne, powerful response there. Wow.
Alex, real quick on an update. It looks like there's 77 people dead, mm-hmm. 50 injured right now. So 127 people affected by the religion of peace right now. We just showed that graphic video. That is very disturbing.
I want to talk to Margaret Howe about this, yeah. One of our great new reporters here, investigative journalist, who's worked some of the biggest news agencies in the world. I want to get her unfiltered take, because other places she worked before, they totally controlled everything she could say. I want to point out, I have no idea what she's about to say. This is just all just, you know, honest response here. But no, come back, dude. Come back, because you're our news director here, and you're the guy that literally, it works for me so many nights at like 8 or 9 at night. You even bring your kids up to the office when we work together to try to fight this tyranny, because we understand desperately that it isn't just Islam. It's this globalist program, and we understand, we physically feel, you and I talk about this.
Yeah.
I say, I feel bad you're at my house at 9 o'clock, or I feel bad you're here at 8 working. And you're like, hey, these are my kids.
We don't have a choice. We don't have a choice.
I mean, what is it like for you to see this? I mean, what is it like to be called an Islamophobe and a right-winger when, to me, you're like a real liberal? I mean, you're a, you know, reggae guy, jazz band guy, anti-drug war, anti-police state. What's it like for you to go out to these rallies and be called a racist?
Well, it's really disturbing, because I'm definitely anti-police brutality and when the police go too far, and militarized police in general. But what we have going on now is a complete turnaround of that paradigm, of where we did have legitimate beefs with how the police were working. I think we were making headroads into that. Now all that's gone.
We don't want to shoot them in the back of the head.
Right. And, you know, I've been arrested just for shooting video in Pittsburgh. So I've seen what happens. I've had the sound cannons turned on me. I've been shot with tear gas.
We've seen cops beat women on bicycles. And when they do it, we call for their arrest.
Exactly.
Just like jihadis.
Exactly. Right. But like you said, Alex, we don't really have a choice in this matter not to do anything. The time for thinking about acting is gone. We have to act. And that's why we're going to the RNC. I was up till 4 a.m. last night. I just could not go to sleep. And I don't know if it was a premonition of this or just like of thinking
coming.
About what's going to go on at the RNC. They had 100,000 protesters in New York 4 years ago. I think we're going to have triple that. 300,000 people in a smaller area with not as much infrastructure. You have a 3-hour meeting with the head of Black Lives Matter at the White House. Who gets a 3-hour meeting with the president?
Nobody. They're planning something big.
Unless they're planning something big.
Hey, it's like they say, if this is true, don't let him escape. Escape is not our plan.
Yeah, exactly.
We're going to be there.
Exactly. And, we're going to be there.
Yeah.
So go ahead and get Margaret's take on this. I'm going to go check on a few other things.
No, we got time. We're live. Huge audience. We're right now. This is what it's all about. Any other points, Paul? Paul Watson chimed in earlier. Any other points, dude?
Well, I think at this point, France has no choice but to take action at this point. They have to really start checking their borders, I think sealing their borders at this point, and not letting anybody in.
They have to take the families and the support networks that are involved,
yeah,
and they have to prosecute them and throw their ass under the jail. They used to take Frenchmen 200 years ago, 150 years ago, who stole a loaf of bread, famously, and put them on Devil's Island. Okay, that was wrong. So we have this liberal reform against that. Fine. Throw their ass on a desert island, man.
127 people now have been affected by this. Some of these 50 that are injured might not make it.
Yeah, their rights, okay? Right. Not be run over by some nut.
And they were celebrating their revolution, which wasn't a very good revolution. It was a lot different than the American Revolution. It was very bloody.
The point is, though, they're attacking them on their day. They're announcing, we've taken over. Great points, exactly. Rob Dew. Can you believe that Facebook won't let us say Islamic terror?
Well, that, you know, cutting communication, of course, is a tactic used in war. And this is a war. And that's a tactic that they use.
That's it. I know. Go ahead, Leanne. That's a great point. We are literally, okay, then let me ask you this question. I want to go to Margaret because she's sitting there politely waiting. But this is a great brainstorm. And I want to ask Margaret this question too. It is war. With the major mega banks, with the big media that helped fund the Arab Spring, Facebook helped run it, and they won't let us point out the word it is. I watch the news, they won't say it. It's a war. Who's running it?
The president won't say it. Hillary Clinton refuses to say it until they forced her hand the other day. But even then, she came right out and said, but they're not the enemy. Oh, let's, you know, it is a tactic used in war, just like we're seeing with these communication outages across the country on tomorrow, the Day of Rage, that they're going to be shutting down all of these power outages with Comcast and things like that in the cities where it just so happens these things are going on.
They're testing the internet kill switch. I mean, this is a test at martial law.
No, this is...
I'm like 50 times my spidey senses ever. I'm just like... What do you think's going on, Margaret? Oh, my gosh.
Well, first of all, they're not reporting the real numbers. They're sanitizing the photographs. We're not supposed to see anything. I've been on the ground of suicide bombings. I know what this looks like, and I can't help it. I'm just tearing up for these people because I can only imagine... It just breaks my heart. It makes me so angry.
They're being dehumanized.
Exactly. And I'm sorry to cut you off. There's a Trojan horse aspect to this. They're through the gate. I'm a political scientist. I've studied this stuff for 9 years. In my opinion, it's over for them. There's no recourse. There's no revolutionary period.
France has fallen.
France is done. And my question is, if they're not reporting the real numbers here, at what point are we where France was 5 years ago, 6 years ago?
At what point
are they going to actually start pulling in these real numbers? You're absolutely right. You go to the mall, that scares the hell out of me. I hate seeing that. It's everywhere. I come from a tiny town in Kentucky, and we have four huge mosques. Where do they come from? You tell me. I'm so sorry. This makes me so emotional because I know what these people are dealing with. I've been on the ground of this stuff, and I hate it. I hate to see it.
Tell folks where you've been. You've worked for big U.S.
I flew on New Year's Eve a few years ago to cover a suicide bomber. I got on the ground and you could smell the stench of those bodies, and I'm so sick of this shit. I'm sorry. I told my mom,
I'm not going to cuss anymore.
I promised my mom I wouldn't do that anymore, but my point is this makes me so angry, and the only thing that's worse than what's happening right now is the fact that we're going to have these apologists get on social media and tell us that Islam is not our adversary. I am so sick of this. I mean, I'm sorry I'm yelling.
Tell folks, because you've worked for U.S. corporations, you've worked for RT, and you've been there when this is going on.
I've been in Muslim countries where I'm afraid to show my hair. Do we want this here? That's my question. I'm a simple person. I just wanted to be educated.
Why does Gloria Steinem support this?
Do we really want to get to a place where we're afraid to go out in public and show our hair and our arms? No. I mean, honestly, that's where we are. That's where we are. I'm sorry. That's where we are. And the Trojan horses through the gate.
I'm a beggar because I'm all for you showing your arms. So it's horrible. it is sick. Leanne, I love the fact she's on fire. Isn't that awesome?
No. Yeah.
That's resistance. And look, what's scary is Fox will hardly cover it. And they're the controlled right-wing BS. The other channels won't even cover what's happening. It's really a weird feeling. You know, we're reaching millions of people right now. And in the aggregate, even more than that. It's crazy, though, that to know we're one of the only, I don't want to be one of the only outposts resisting this. Why aren't other people awake, Margaret?
They are controlled by a Marxist puppet master. I was looking at comments that Soros said. He admitted the involvement in the migrant crisis, and he said natural borders are a problem. So we've been conditioned and dumbed down and dumbed down. We've been made to feel like we're bigots and we're racist. God forbid you should stand up and say this is wrong. You know, if you have any guts, you are a... I've been called every single name online. I'm so tired of it. But I'm telling you... There's a louder voice when you go into a hospital room where you've seen somebody who survived a suicide bombing, just barely, your thought process begins to change a little bit here. I'm not apologizing for these bastards. I'm not getting online. We have to call this for what it is. That's a major weapon in this fight.
I just don't get how the left says, don't say you want brownies, it's racist, to create all this racist garbage so we don't get along. And then, don't have peanut butter and jelly sandwiches or don't have a Halloween party. But then they love Islam. I just don't get it.
Right. Well, I really truly think it's demonic. I mean, that's the only cover up that you have these people on the far end of this, the radical Islamists, they truly believe this is end of days for them. And they take their religion very seriously.
Well, that's what the cop killer in Dallas said. This is the end of the world.
Right.
This is the end.
And their book, their book tells them, kill the infidel. It's telling them to go.
So here's what I'm saying. Why doesn't he kick the ass of the arrogant cop that's out of line and risk his life there? I get it. I've gotten arrested. I've gotten in bad cops' faces. I mean, I can't stand arrogant thugs in a badge and a gun. That's just a criminal. I mean, I've literally been arrested many times. I've been sued. I've been beat up. I mean, I don't like thug cops, but you don't just go shoot some cop pumping gas because some cop was an asshole to you 6 months ago. I mean, whatever happened to going after who did it to you?
Right.
I don't understand this thing where, oh, well, a cop shot somebody in Minnesota, so let's go shoot some cops in Dallas, you know? Right.
One of the best police departments that's actually been working on reform. Let's go after the department.
I'm about to say super liberal. The mayor is like a social justice warrior. Well, that's another question. Why does the Islamicist and Black Lives Matter and other groups tend to attack people that kiss their butt?
I don't know. It's like they see that you have the little bit of weakness there, and so they latch onto it. They see, oh, well, you're buying into this BS that I'm spewing, so I'm going to go ahead and turn you all the way.
Well, it's all a war against humanity. It's all divide and conquer. Joe Biggs is popping in. I see he's there in front of the George Washington. There, if you're watching us on TV, radio listeners, InfoWars.com/show for all the free feeds. Joe, what is your view on all this?
Well, we're being told that our biggest threat here in America is local law enforcement and the fact that you could be killed by local law enforcement and gunned down for just walking down the road. But let's talk about the real threat in the world.
They shoot 980 people a year.
Let me give you the list of Islamic terror attacks in 2015 alone. 2,867, which left 27,653 people killed. 26,150 were injured. Now let's go over the last 30 days from the Religion of Peace. 189 Islamic attacks in 31 countries, in which 1,494 people were killed and 1,869 people were injured. And yet we're told to worry about the police when we have open borders. We have a president could care less. He's allowing these people to come
and
in.
Cops kill total less than 1,000 people a year. I don't like some of the arrogance. I don't like the checkpoints. I don't like the revenue generation. That's all the Fed. I don't like the TSA. I'm the guy that attacked. We wrote the book on it. But it's the Congress that did it. Blame the kingpins, not the minions, Joe. Exactly. And so it's a total red herring. Why is our enemy media run by globalists that suppress the cancer treatments, that are trying to suppress our vitamins, that are trying to suppress our families? Our known enemy tells us hate the local government because they're going to bully the local government into capitulating, Leanne.
And they want to do away with the police force here so they can bring in the UN.
Which they're now saying the UN runs this. Listen, I knew this was coming, but to see it happening, I'm literally in the twilight zone. Leanne, what is it like for you? You've been here 4 years. You already were so smart when you got here, UT degree, TV shows, you name it. But what is it like for you to actually live this and be immersed in it?
Honestly, I just feel like we're almost speaking it into being. And so what can we do to speak a different reality into being, to help people wake up to this? You know, I think Margaret nailed it.
Yeah, we don't want anybody to die, not Muslims.
We need to call this what it is so that we can identify the problem instead of allowing all the darkness to just take over.
You just said it, though. They won't let us speak it.
Right.
Yeah, you dare not say radical Islam. Dare not say radical Muslim. Dare not say that there's a problem with that happening right now because it could be offensive. Meanwhile, people who would rather be offended are being mowed down. Mm-hmm. People are being killed. They're being driven over.
You're right.
They're being shot. They're being blown up. You ban the guns. Guess what they're going to do? They're going to build IEDs in the roads like they did in Fallujah. You ban guns. Guess what's going to happen? More car bombs, like a car bomb that went off today in Nevada, which I have a special report on as well. There's a lot of crazy things happening.
Oh, they cover it up. I've talked to people. There's attacks on power plants, nuke plants. I'll tell you, Islam is on the march right now. But let's talk geopolitically, Margaret and Leanne and Joe, and whoever else wants to pop in here from the crew, just come to the mic. The larger globalist program is using Islam, Orthodox Islam, Saudi Arabian, Sunni, Wahhabist stuff to create destabilization. But there is an evil above that that's against all of humanity, including the average Muslim, who I don't think is a bad person. They're oppressed in a cult system, and we want to free them. We're all just humans with souls. What do you think the larger plan is, though, as this goes into high gear?
Well, I think that there's a dark, sinister force that understands the nature of this radical demon, first of all. And I think that it is manipulating it in a way. And you pointed out that, and I want to stress that, too, because I've known really great people and they happen to be Muslim. We're talking about, if you look at numbers here, so radical Islam, those who practice radical Islam, it's only about 25%. That's what they're saying. Well, if there are a billion Muslims in the world and 25% of them are radicalized, that's more than our population. So we have a serious problem with
hundreds of millions.
Oh, my God. So we've got a problem. That's our first thing, this dark, sinister force.
And that's who admits now they're up to 36%.
3%.
As they get more confident, it's 10, 20, 30. It's like... I'm sorry, go ahead.
Think about the term 3%er, though. 3% of those people stood up and we came here to America. So you're telling me 25% are radical? That's way more. Yeah,
3%
that's a lot of people.
Founded America and kicked the crown's ass.
So with 25% radical Islam, that is out of control. That's a lot of people. And then you looked at the numbers.
Islam
that
Paul is only probing, though. It's just like a kaiju attack, to use that analogy of that cheesy movie. But it's true. Every attack's double. They're only probing in these first attacks, Joe. You experienced that in the Middle East, right?
Yeah, that's what they always do. They always want to find weak points. And the weak points are these pray for knees, pray for Paris, pray for this and that. Praying for somebody is not going to bring them back. Changing your profile picture is not going to bring back the dead. No, what you've done is you've taken the right away from the people to defend themselves, and now they are soft targets.
I want to say
and
that. The
radical
the so-called
Islamists
leftists
see that
are allied with Islam and the globalists, you literally have aided and abetted these new murders. And I'm fighting to stop the drone attacks. I'm fighting to stop the wars. Our wars are to take out the Muslim groups that aren't radical.
Right.
Again, Margaret and Leanne.
Yeah, that's absolutely right. So just taking this back to this, I can't leave you with this enough. So the Trojan horse aspect, I care about our country. I care about our civilization. I want to make sure that people within the sound of my voice understand that this is still within their power. And it's the understanding of what we're doing, what we're facing, and calling out this bullshit government for what it is and saying, you're not going to do this. You're not going to dump 2,000, 3,000 people in my community, not vetted. You know, give them all of food stamp cards, put them up in housing, and then wait a couple of years and let's see this happen over and over and over and over. And people really need to take a stand and stand on their own ground and say, you are not doing this to our town. I think right. That's where I want to go with that, because honestly, it comes down to people saying no. You just have.
Some German towns have right. Like 100 people. They'll put 700 migrants home.
Yeah. And let them totally take over the town.
And I literally see a free woman walking around.
Get
and
people
just
out of their own homes and say,
there's
we need to make room for all
Syrian
these
refugees in Philadelphia. It's out of control. There's mm-hmm. tons of camps all over Amarillo.
Meanwhile, the Syrian. State Department saying right. No 10,000, no 20,000. It's just such a masked lie.
And the president was
what
so proud in September, tweeting out, well, we're going to be increasing the number of refugees we admit to the U.S. to 100,000 per year.
And again, and remember two, 3 years ago, they said Germany was 100,000, was over a million?
Right.
They're all, it's the same scam, Joe.
We were laughed at when we were covering stuff at the border, talking about how prayer rugs were found.
Yeah.
And, you know, all these different books, Korans and things like that. Like, oh, that's a conspiracy theory. These kind of people aren't coming over.
Well, let me ask
yeah,
you
they're
this
coming
question
over
then,
by the
Joe.
Southern border. They're coming
Why
over.
Why do you think Republican leadership with Obama is doing this? What's their end game?
They want more power. They want more money. A lot of these guys are in bed with Obama. A lot of them are allowing it. A lot of them want to keep their power. We have money and war. The more times we fight, the more war we have, the more fear we have, the more the Republican Party makes, the more that Obama makes. These people are all in bed together. You know, hopefully we can get someone like Donald Trump to stand up, rise up, and defeat the enemy and call it what it is. Because you know what? Radical Islam exists. I've said it. I will say it again, and I will die saying it. It
well,
exists.
Let's go further. Let's go further. There was a time, even a few years ago, I wouldn't even say radical Islam, because I was just trying to make everybody work together, and I don't want to go down this route. But this is clearly the globalist plan now. This is Orthodox Islam. This is what Saudi Arabia has done. It's what the globalists have done. This has taken Islam over. Whatever it was before, this is it. And it's here, and it's being brought in, and I'm not going to put a bag over my daughter's heads.
Mm-hmm. And we have people in America who are proudly going out, waving communist flags, right, burning the American flag, spitting on freedom, attacking liberty-loving Americans because America's they love evils, the Constitution.
Do they realize how hellish communist countries are?
Oh, they have no idea, and they need to be given a one-way ticket there just to go take a little vacation.
Communists,
check it out.
Exactly, can't ever even make cars.
Right.
The Venezuelan government is in charge of food now. They just talked about that
today.
The
military, right.
The military and the government is over the food rations now in Venezuela.
And everything's collapsing.
That's what they want. They want that here in America.
And Bernie said Venezuela's the model, Margaret.
Oh, man. Well, speaking of a communist country, I lived in Russia myself, and they regulate. If they think that a group is a threat, they regulate them. They control them by putting into areas. They will accept, for example, I lived in Moscow. They would have Muslim areas, but they wouldn't allow them to put up mosques everywhere. They were very restricted, very contained. We don't do that. We've got an open policy here, and we're seeing the effects of that. I just want to say this in one point. Back to the burqa issue.
Yeah, take your time. Each one of you, everybody, take your time.
I really feel for these women, and I don't mean to attack. You know, I think that they're victimized by that stupid burqa. I think that it's such a victimization.
Well, there's Stockholm syndrome. A lot of them will say, I want this. Mm-hmm. Well, yeah, because they kill you and you're a little girl. You need to put it on.
It's just, going back to the point of seeing that at the mall, it just makes me so physically ill. I want to rip it off is what mm-hmm. I want to do. I'm so afraid that one of these days I am and I'm actually.
And the weird arrogant guy, like, they're always real arrogant and they dress like real gangster now. They're like, it's just like,
There's videos of women in Saudi Arabia that are having their heads chopped off for not being covered to a man's liking.
Yeah, he saw
There's
their
no
ankles.
Judge and jury. They walk out with a sword. They will stop traffic. The Saudi Arabian police will stop traffic and allow this man to drag his wife or whatever out of the car, pull out a sword, and chop their head off. And that's who Hillary Clinton wants to bring
Hillary,
in.
Hillary, who gets her money, and Gloria Steinem to Saudi Arabia.
Well, yeah,
we should sign a petition to ship them out of here.
Yeah, let them go check it out. And let's not forget that it was the majority of moderate Muslims who agreed that you can lightly beat your wife, you know, or that beheading is an appropriate response.
What about extremely spoil them?
Yeah, I mean, that's you sound like an extremist right now. This and that's the Western civilization that they want to destroy. They want to see beautiful women inside black bags.
We're bringing people
guys.
In. We're bringing
Look
people
at these
in
guys.
And not
and
making
I
them assimilate.
Talk about Saudi Arabia. So you have a lot of people right now, whenever there's a terror attack, they always come out and say, white
people. No wonder he wants women to be slaves. You think that son of a bitch can get women? I mean, look at that dumb bastard.
Hideous.
Look at those scumbags. I mean, those are a bunch of freakazoids, man.
That's why they have to take sex slaves.
Aloha snack bar.
Yeah, well, Saudi Arabia, okay, a lot of people right now in response to this attack, they're saying, we're not going to pray for Nice until people pray for the Middle East and stop the empire from going there and destroying these countries. Well, Hillary Clinton, let's not forget that there was a chain of emails going around where she was saying, what a great Christmas present we gave Saudi Arabia during her time there at the State Department, gave them billions of dollars worth of weapons mm-hmm. that they then used to go and do all of these airstrikes in Yemen, killing tons of innocent people, attacking hospitals, all these things. So she's funding Saudi Arabia, giving them, they're like one of the largest buyers of weapons that we manufacture here in the U.S.
Sure, not to mention Paul Joseph Watson. Syria.
Yeah. Hey, Paul Joseph Watson just tweeted out, he's got some information. The Nice terrorist is a Muslim from Tunisia. Image may shock. That is, imagine it might shock. So yeah. That's what he just tweeted out.
And of course, I was going to guess Tunisia because that's what mainly Tunisia or Morocco if it's France. And then go, a Frenchman born in Morocco.
I just got in a drive home from the airport from someone from Tunisia.
Again, a lot of these Muslims are actually heretics. They just want to be in freedom.
Right.
So there are a lot of them. I'm going to explain. It's the leaders that are bad.
Look at the Muslims that are here in America that agree with Sharia law. And yet we do not make them assimilate. They hate our ways. They hate what we stand for.
I've seen news articles where the Sharia family sexually mutilated their daughter, but it's okay. And the woman was beaten, but the police were told to stand down because it's their culture.
There was a sergeant first class in the U.S. Army Special Forces who stopped a man who was sexually assaulting this woman's boy. The woman came up to the special forces officer who was training and said, hey, my son was raped by one of the police officers that you guys are training over in Afghanistan. And he brought that up. When I was in Afghanistan, we saw that so many times, and we brought that information to the forefront. It was shot down by the State Department. Hillary Clinton released a letter, and I did a report on this a while back, released a letter saying, no, that's not rape. That's part of their culture. These are the kind of ideals she supports. She supports radical Islam. She supports the rape of these young boys they call the Bachabaz. It is out of control.
It is out of control.
We have to assimilate to their culture of rape.
I got to say, the radio show during the day is powerful, but I think this particular just up here at night. I used to be a radio host at night. I love it. Everybody's awake. We're really being real. It's just like, I'm real during the day, but it's like you're kind of the day. It's like, this is like, boom. We're just saying what we really think. I want to get final comments from whoever wants to comment. Margaret, Hal, Leanne McAdoo, Joe Biggs, anybody else in the crew. I don't care if it's Joe Jennings or Allie or whoever's up here at night working. And we're going to air what was going to be the nightly news after that.
Well, I know there was reports initially coming out of Sky News, BBC, saying that this was possibly retaliation for Brexit.
Now it's 80-something dead.
People don't drive trucks for a mile through crowds because of Brexit. There's only one group right now that is causing massive terror on a massive scale. We had people tweeting out, oh, well, Christians are killing people everywhere. No, they're not. No, they're not. Maybe thousands of years ago.
Weirdo leftist,
there's
man.
One group, and we have to call it what it is. We have to identify our enemy, and we can't allow them to cut off the communication because we are in an information war.
We got to call it Orthodox Islam. Terrorism. Absolutely. Go ahead.
No, I just want to say that anybody looking at this who might not be a news junkie like we are, it's overwhelming, and I can only imagine. You just don't know what to do about all this information, and I just want to say be encouraged because we're not where France is. We're not there yet. And we have a hope and a prayer. And honestly, this is not about bashing Muslim people for me. This is about identifying a radical extremist ideology.
Again, we even have to apologize. Cancer. They just killed more people.
Yeah,
Facebook won't let us say who even did it. And we're even apologizing, which I do
it's
too.
It's a cancer that we're talking about here that needs to be uprooted before it takes over the whole body. And that's where we are. There is a Trojan horse that's entering our gates too. And honestly, it just... People, the biggest weapon that you have is not being afraid. And I learned that myself. I used to be an apologist. I used to say, just everything. I didn't want to offend anybody. But the honest answer here is you cannot be afraid to confront this. And hopefully that's what we're doing tonight.
You're totally right. And I don't want to ask all of you this question, then Joe Biggs. Is there any level of murder that the controlled left won't defend from Islam? Mm-hmm. Because it's like cult-like. I mean, I never really even bashed Islam because I was just trying to stop the destabilization. I was just trying to stop the globalist takeover to turn it into a weapon. They had, like, major movies. Who's the guy that does, like, Portlandia and all that? What's that famous comedian's name?
I'm not sure.
David Cross, I think? He has,
David Cross, yeah.
Movies where it goes, Alex Jones is an evil Islamophobe. And it's like, and he hates women. They always go, he hates women and Muslims. Like Muslims protect women. And so, and I pick up on this, and I'm like, you know what? You're telling me that. Like, you're afraid I'm going to do it. Let me look, It's just so weird. So is there any level? Because, the German ministers and others get raped by Muslims. They blame it on Germans and admit that later. Is there nothing they won't put up with, Margaret?
In answer to your question, is there nothing they won't put up with? No, of course not. You can be raped in the streets. Your children can, God knows what. There's no level. And until there is that honesty, and you're absolutely right, it's an honesty. You've got to be honest with yourself and step out from behind the shadow. And it's a tough thing to do. And I commend anybody who does it. But if you take a stand against this, I'm just going to tell you, you're going to be labeled as a racist, as a bigot, as an Islamophobic. You're going to be outcast and shunned. But honestly,
well, I think it's good to be outcast from people to do this.
I mean, it is a do or die moment. That's what this is.
Yeah, we got to break with the brainwash. Because you're right, it's a cognitive dissonance point of learned helplessness, the Overton window, mass Stockholm syndrome.
Right.
Because where it's just like, if you accept this, there's nothing you won't put up with.
Right. Well, we're seeing that in Sweden, Germany, these other places where women are getting raped, children are getting raped, but it is happening here now. Was it in Ohio where the young girl was raped by young boys? And they're telling you, don't talk about it.
They cover it up.
They're putting you in jail. We're daring to speak out about this. So it's already beginning to creep here where they are telling us that we have to, don't offend the Muslims, don't offend this community, assimilate. This is their culture. No, this is our culture. This is our country.
Hands off Wonder Woman.
Here. And you're absolutely right. Like, we aren't there yet. We do have time to fight back against this. And it's time to stop being...
That was awesome.
What is it like, though? What is it like for you to see all the so-called leftist women that supposedly represent women defending this? Is that frustrating?
Well, one of the things that's kind of infuriating about Twitter, but I'm taking notes from Watson, and I'm just going for it rather than holding back. But I just... If one person tweets out hashtag not all Muslims, like as soon as a terror attack, it's like, obviously, if it was all Muslims, we'd all be dead because there's a billion Muslims. We get that. But we need to understand that
billions, 300 million.
Yeah, I mean, this is a real issue. This is happening here. It's creeping into this country. These are people who want to kill you. They want to rape your children. They want to rape your wives, your daughters. They do not care. And this is coming. It doesn't matter.
It's a warlike cult where they indoctrinate from birth and then sleeper cell. Exactly. I'm just done. And then I'm blamed as I'm mean because I don't want them throwing gays off buildings.
Yeah. And we shouldn't have to apologize
every 2 seconds. We shouldn't have to apologize every time there's attack and go, well, not all Muslims. Well, obviously not all Muslims, like was just said a second ago.
But it's Islam doing it. But it's okay
for us to say there's radical Islam. Mm-hmm. We should be able to say that. If some white guy goes on a killing rampage, guess what? That guy is an idiot.
Well, I'm not going to be offended by it when the news comes out and goes,
A white guy went into a theater and killed everybody. I'm not going to be offended by that because it's not me. I'm an individual.
It's directed by the House of Saud with the globalists in a larger destabilization program. We have to stop it. We have to shut it off. We have to say most of these people don't have jobs. They're getting put on welfare. No, no, no. You're not coming in. All right. We're going to go now here in just a few minutes to parts of the news that were taped at 5:30 when this all broke. I want to thank the crew for working so hard, but I know it's not hard to get you to do it. You're passionate. You're true classical Americana, Renaissance, Enlightenment liberals, which means more freedom for everybody, more tolerance, more openness, more language, more debate. And I want to thank Joe. I want to thank all the rest of the great crew, people behind the scenes nobody ever sees that make this possible. I'm going to go home and try to put my kids to bed and then get up at 7 in the morning and work out and do research and come up here and do the show again. We're going to have all of you again, I think, tomorrow back on the broadcast as well. We got Trump suspending his VP pick and so much more. Let's get 1 minute from each person that wants to pop in, and then we're done. Joe Biggs?
Just wake up. You know, this is happening by design. The borders are open for a reason. We see this happening, unfolding. You've been calling it for years, and it is now in fruition. It is now happening. So wake up. This is the plan they want. They want to destabilize America because it's the biggest threat to this world government while the entire world is collapsing to install a one world government and bring in the UN.
And they are officially saying it. It's no longer even our opinion. I can't believe it. I'm actually pinching myself on a daily basis, Margaret.
I want to leave this on a comical note. You know, any women listening to this, Do It for Denmark comes to mind. And we're being outbred in our own civilization. And I love your culture war speech just now. And perhaps we could take this back if we could just try to start outnumbering. And I think maybe that's the direction we should
take. We're going to go make some
I'd be all happy to have a bunch of brown people that were libertarians and patriots. The thing is, it's just the globalists are funding this to bring out everything. Leanne?
I agree. I think we have enough time to turn this around. And, you know, if it is
speaking of the making Christians, some babies out there, or,
you know, going, yeah. building making up our babies. Own civilization and not being afraid to say, this is our culture. This is the Western civilization is great. We have done so many wonderful things. Stop making them force you to apologize because they bring up false tactics and false things from hundreds of years ago when every single country that is around was created on conquest and slavery.
Exactly.
It's not just the United States of America, the greatest nation ever.
And the Muslim orthodoxy of Saudi Arabia is like the most Stone Age crap ever. I mean, it's just crazy. All right, great.
That's who I was talking about outbreeding, just really quickly. Yes. That's who we need to outbreed. Forgive me for interrupting you. I just want to...
No, you're right. Here's the deal. Whether it's Japan or whether it's any advanced civilization, Italy, I don't want the Italians to go away. They're all not having kids. They're all dying.
No, and that's something that the imams...
brag about.
They brag about, and they talk about that being something that they...
Yeah, I'm not getting any cool cars or sunglasses from Saudi Arabia.
This is a long-term war for them. This is a long-term war for them, that's okay? Right. This is a holy war for them, and they are taking the long route there. They're playing chess.
Yeah, they believe they're getting dominion, and it's a bunch of guys in, like, Santa Claus outfits, like with women chained up? Man, is that really who humans are?
No.
I mean, how the hell did slave trading Bedouins end up ruling this religion and taking over? And the truth is, they're just long-term, they're deceptive, and they're not giving up, and we're not giving up. They teach, when I was in school, that the Crusades were this evil, horrible thing. And I'm like, excuse me, I remember in high school, the Crusades were launched after 500 years of Islamic invasion when they almost took Rome, they almost took Krakow in Poland. I mean, we almost lost everything. They're like, yeah, but it was evil to fight back against that. I'm like,
right.
Why are you teaching that? Well, I mean, it's like, it's good that Constantinople fell, Alex. The freedom will soon be here. And they're just like, okay, are you a Muslim? No, but I'm a leftist, and there'll soon be freedom. And it's like, I guess they think they're going to get a slave dungeon or something. I don't know.
Well, that's the prophecy that they're wanting to see fulfilled. Is that is?
Well, it's not going to happen. Ladies and the rest of the crew, I'm sorry they're not wearing burgers. You can go right to hell. That's what I have to say to all that. To all of you out there that don't like what we're saying, if it's so bad, get the hell out. And we're going to go now to the segments of the news that you've not yet seen that were taped earlier. And Lord willing, we'll be back tomorrow, 11 a.m. Central Standard Time for the big kickoff of the worldwide broadcast. This has been great to have you guys back in. Thanks to the rest of the crew and the people like just everybody back there, people like Joe Jennings, everybody else. We'll see you back tomorrow. God bless.
I'm Ashley Beckford for InfoWars.com. I'm going out today on the streets of Austin, Texas, to find out what people know about the Day of Rage protests occurring on July 15th in light of the recent police shootings. Anonymous is coming out and having, like, National Day of Rage in several different cities in order to protest these police shootings that have been happening. What do you think about that?
Actually, I'd rather not speak on this, so thank you.
Do you want to, could you answer one question about Bernie?
Thank you.
No? What do you feel about nonviolent protests about, you know, these recent police shootings? Do you think it's a good thing?
I think nonviolence is probably the better option in most cases,
Did you hear about the Day of Rage that they're having tomorrow, promoted by Anonymous over the police shootings?
Oh, I have not heard anything about that, no.
I don't really know enough to say, honestly.
Do you think nonviolent protest is a good way to combat these police shootings?
Honestly, I think that's the only way we'll actually get through. Violence begets violence. You know, I think Martin Luther King Jr. was right on. And look at all the good works that nonviolence has helped. So I think we have to stop somewhere. And so, yeah, I'm really supporting it and looking forward to it.
I wanted to know if you think it's a coincidence that there's also communications outages in a lot of these cities where they're going to be protesting tomorrow.
Well, frankly, I don't know. If there's a relationship between both things is beyond my knowledge.
Do you think it's a coincidence that there have been a lot of outages with Comcast and other communications providers during the same time?
Not a big believer in coincidences.
Okay.
Yeah, I think it's good to have a nonviolent protest just because if you fight violence with violence, it just doesn't do any good.
And could it be a coincidence or maybe something more that there are going to be communications outages, like Comcast has a lot of down communication right now during those protests in the same areas?
I think it might be a coincidence, maybe, if Anonymous is trying to wage a war against them.
I mean, a nonviolence protest to combat previous violence, I think that's always the way to go, but it's really hard to achieve in a lot of situations.
In light of the recent terror attacks in Nice, the Day of Rage protests are taking on a new ominous tone. The widespread Comcast outages may affect communication during these protests.
Welcome back. Joining me in studio now, Joe Biggs and Margaret Howell. And we're going to talk a little bit about what to expect in the coming weeks at the RNC and the DNC. Now, we have seen a week of violence here, massive protests all around the country. And we know that there are going to be some more protests planned for the Republican as well as the Democratic convention. Millions of dollars being spent in these cities preparing for this. And of course, they had, you know, some really amazing security plans in place, but now after what happened in Dallas, they're having to change their tune. So what do you guys expect? What's happening there at the RNC first?
I mean, it's going to be interesting. I mean, we saw how the Philadelphia reacted to the Pope coming in, the large security measures that they had to take over the area. It's only going to get worse now that we have presidential frontrunner Donald Trump coming in, the many speakers, the paid agitators, George Soros money being funneled in to this area. Police are coming in from Austin to Cleveland to go help. There's police coming in from different counties, different cities, different states to help try to quieten the civil unrest that we know is going to happen. Black Lives Matter is openly coming out saying they're bringing in people. You've got the leader of Black Lives Matter, DeRay McKesson, met with Obama yesterday at the White House for 3 hours. Mm-hmm. 24 hours after Obama attended the funeral of the police officers that died in Dallas.
And turned it into a political...
That's what they always do.
There. We know that they're busing at 8,000 as well. And you mentioned McKesson. We understand that these protests are going to be in full force. But what's interesting to me, Leanne, the do not bring list does not include guns. So during the RNC, things are banned, like water guns, throwing feces, of course.
Tennis balls. Don't,
tennis balls, but not actually weapons. You can bring a loaded gun with you if you have the permit to do it. So it looks like if they really wanted to quell the violence that they're expecting, they might want to go ahead and maybe right. just take it a step.
Well, Ohio has the open carry law, so you don't even have to have a permit like you do here in Texas to be able to open carry or conceal carry. You know, you already have Black Panthers coming out of the new Black Panthers saying that they will be open carrying at these rallies. I got word that the Hell's Angels are going to be there. A large group of Oath Keepers will be there as well. You know, the interesting thing is, though, is like you said, guns are allowed because of the law. Right. But then they go and ban these stupid things like tennis balls, water bottles, so gas masks.
Yeah, it's called in the Second Amendment everywhere except for the RNC, basically.
Right. Well, and of course, and you know, the Democrats are really enjoying this because they're saying, well, look at your gun laws are now backfiring on you because, of course, this is going to create a security nightmare for the Secret Service and all of these other security groups that are trying to protect the First Amendment rights and Second Amendment rights of people who are allowed to be out there doing that. But there's also major security concerns, especially considering this past week, what we've seen.
Yeah, there's definitely some trickery going on. They're definitely going to use that open carry law against the right, against the people who want to have the constitutional carry, the right to protect themselves. They want someone like a new Black Panther Party to pull a gun, or they want someone that's just out on the street watching what's going on to pull their gun and then blame it on the right. And then see, this isn't going to work out. We need to have stricter gun laws.
Exactly. Well, we know they're always looking for an opportunity to exploit situations like this. And, you know, it will remain to be seen what is going to happen there. But we do know that there is going to be some chaos at the Republican convention, both outside of the walls as well as in. So what are some of the RNC rules that they're kind of mulling over to...
Right. Well, we know that the establishment, so they're after Trump. They cannot stand this. They're going to pull all stops to a last-ditch effort from my research to try and stop this. Now, the funny part about this, Leanne, in 2012, the establishment Republicans, they made it harder for insurgent delegates to challenge a GOP nominee on the convention floor. They never anticipated Trump, of course, so this rule is biting them in the tail at the moment, which I love, frankly. We see in full force the Never Trump movement coming out, slamming Trump repeatedly. People like Bill Kristol, Mitt Romney, calling him racist, misogynistic, you know, the bigotry is off the charts. I'm paraphrasing Mitt Romney. Last-ditch effort on the inside as well as the outside. There is a full-on war waged. But the Never Trump movement has failed. You think that, you know, by the time we get to that, we're 17 hours out. On Sunday, there's a kickoff, and then Monday. So Trump's doing his VP pick, of course, and they're doing everything they can, the establishment behind the scenes. But the rules are biting them in the butt, unfortunately. Sorry about that, guys.
No, well, it's very true. And, you know, people are sort of anticipating that. And I find that Never Trump argument interesting because they say that it's never Trump because they believe in true conservatism, so they'd rather elect Hillary. It's like, what are you talking about? You're shooting yourself in the foot. But then, of course, as we move on to the Democratic convention, they're talking about strikes there. So roughly 1,000 of the city's airport workers have voted overwhelmingly to strike. These are wheelchair attendants, baggage handlers, and airport cleaners, among other people. So that is in addition to the possibility of up to 1 million protesters
from a plethora of activist groups who are saying they're going to be descending upon these two conventions.
Well, think about, look at the numbers in Philadelphia, the amount of Democrats who switched over to Republican. It's going to be interesting because a lot of people think that most of the chaos is going to be at the RNC, but you're going to see a lot of these people in Philadelphia. The RNC is going to set the tone for how the rest of this is going to go, and it's going to be intense. Like you said earlier, the amount of security that was there for the Pope, imagine that, quadruple that. That's what Philadelphia is going to be like. But, I mean, there's already, if you go to the International Action Center, they already have a schedule of planned protests that cover through the entire RNC week in Cleveland. The first one's going to be shut down Trump at the RNC. It'll be where the convention's being held at 4 p.m. And I mean, if you go through this article, there's just tons and tons of different protests going on and how they're talking about they want to stop Trump because of his racism, his Islamophobia, the attacks on immigrants, LGBT, so forth and so on. And I mean, there's so many things wrong with all those because...
Right. Yeah, and of course they're going to be exploiting all of the police murders that have happened in Cleveland that of course have been igniting the these Black Lives Matter protests. So, I mean...
It's going to be a powder keg.
Yeah.
The tweets that were hacked by the Black Lives Matter movement, we covered these hacked tweets in which Loretta Lynch was called into play. And we know that there was a conversation that was leaked out. They want to shut down these conventions any way they can. DNC, RNC, it doesn't matter. The chaos that they're trying to ensue to create a climate of just absolute debauchery, it's unbelievable. And the whole intent of this, you know, Bernie Sanders lost, their candidate lost, and if martial law is declared, there's hope for President Obama to stay in office. These were hacked messages that were actually leaked. So, of course, there's this intent to shut down with mass chaos. There's an underlying agenda there.
Right, and of course, we've seen now the FAA has created a no-fly zone there around the RNC, of course, attempting to censor our Hillary for prison aircraft banners that we had prepared. But this call for martial law and the rumors that the president would get to stay in place, we've been hearing this for a few years now. Could this finally be the moment?
Yeah, I mean, it's been leading up to this point for a while. Look at people like Al Sharpton and Obama. They keep calling for the federalization of police forces. Now, what they do is they demonize these local law enforcement divisions around the country, like it's been going on. They always put a magnifying glass on these isolated incidents. Yeah, there's a lot of people that get killed because of racism. There's a lot of bad cops out there, but we can't say all cops are bad because of that. Just like I can't look at one kind of person and they commit a crime and blame all of them. What's going to happen is they want to create such a civil unrest, such a disturbance that they have to basically abolish local law enforcement, bring in a federalized police force, and then declare martial law and allow Obama to stay in again because he keeps joking. We've seen that. I'm sure we can find takes where he's joked about, well, you know, maybe I could do a third term, you know, wink, wink, you know. That's scary. And this is all leading up to that. Hundreds of thousands of people ready to protest. It's not looking good.
Yeah, and I think what would be even scarier is if Hillary Clinton gets elected and then martial law is declared. And already Al Sharpton, he had prepared a march there, and that was shut down. That was denied because they didn't want to incite any more of that racial division there, of course, in the aftermath of what happened in Dallas. So I think that was very smart on their end, but I'm sure that Sharpton, the race baiter in chief, is going to show up.
He'll call Obama up on the cell phone and ask him what's up. I'm sure he'll get a pass behind the lines and be able to create his own little march out there.
Mm. Well,
with the bullhorn, no,
we'll less. All be there. Yes, we will all be there, probably with bullhorns as well, out on the street. I know Alex Jones is going to be there giving a great speech, and you all will be in the crowd with me. We know you're going to be right where all the action is, Joe Biggs, hopefully with your bulletproof vest on, because those have not been banned in Cleveland. Well, thank you guys so much for joining me, and thank you all for tuning into the show tonight. If you're watching us on YouTube, hit the subscribe button. We'll see you here tomorrow, 7 p.m. Central. We'll be right back.